Good morning, cultists. Welcome back to another Unbalanced Breakfast with CthuLoops. Let's continue in the ashes of Arianda, I believe. Oh, I didn't even notice that dead body actually kind of tumbles. But yeah, let's try to go through this DLC, I guess, somehow. I don't know how. Even the freaking wolves are giving me too much trouble, but you know, it is what it is, I guess, right? Or is that's what they say, at least. Who knows if it is actually what it is, right? I don't know. So I know if I go this way, there's a wolf, and he's gonna yell. Okay, is that enough to summon the other guys? Or am I safe? I think I'm safe. I think he has to howl a little bit more. Oh, okay, so can attack them right now. Okay, good. I thought I had to wait for them to come alive or something? I don't know. Yeah, there's a lot of bloodstains around those trees. That makes sense, I guess. I'm assuming I can't backstab the trees. Should make sense. I mean, I'm saying not being able to backstab makes sense. Not being able to backstab makes sense. That's not what I'm trying to say here. Okay, so I know those guys will aggro me for sure. So let's get my bow out. Maybe try to aggro one of them? I don't know if it's possible. And my arrow went straight over his head. Oh, looks like I can aggro one of them at a time. And if he just manages to navigate his way down, you know, we'll give him a good thrashing. With my sword and shield. Not whatever the hell I was wielding there. Oh god. Seriously? Jesus Christ. What an embarrassment. I'm talking about myself, of course, not talking about him. He did admirably. He actually hit me, which is insane. There's that a headshot? Thank you. Always appreciate getting headshots. Oh! Can you... Oh, got him right in the crotch. You're not having any more babies, my friend. Not that I expect you to have babies as an undead dude, but, you know. Never know, right? I mean, maybe in this world undead people have babies. I mean, I got married and all that, and then I stabbed my wife in the face. Something I plan to avoid with my, real-life girlfriend. You know? Actively plan to avoid that, but, you know. Oh yeah, you see that dodging, my friend? It's the last thing you ever saw, buddy. I'm assuming there's no one else behind you there? Because if there is, I'm screwed. So, yeah, this is where I started, right? Okay, good, I got this follower javelin, which is amazing and exactly what I always wanted out of life, right? Maybe? I don't know. But so far, this DLC has been extremely difficult. Who knows how it'll actually proceed. It features mobs that just swarm you like nobody's business. Seems a little lazy in terms of design, but, you know, it's... What do I know, right? I'm not... Oh god. Big wolf, did you just summon your little wolves, or no, right? That's just... I predict I will probably fall to my death. Maybe? Oh god, can you please fall to your death, actually? I'd really appreciate that. Okay, you're almost there, buddy. Okay, don't. That's the wrong way. That's not how you fall to your death. Come on, man. Come here. Fall to your death, please. Come on, dude. Buddy. Buddy. You can do it. You can do it, man. Do it. Okay, whoa, he actually curves around you. Maybe he can't fall to his death. I'm hoping that he can. I'm still hopeful. Okay, he did a little body slam thing. Which is, you know, good for you and all that. Can you not push me to my death? That'd be amazing, actually. Come on, man, you're almost there. What the hell? I swear, I didn't actually, like, hit it that much. I thought he was at maybe half health or something, but... No. No calling your friends. Okay, good, thank you. Oh, God. Every time you hear, like, even the slightest of panting, I'm just worried that wolves might be called in. And they do their thing, you know, and then just... Nobody's happy, except maybe the wolf. Maybe they're happy about it, the whole situation. So you've got my soul over there, sir. I would like to reclaim it, if at all possible. And maybe avoid the... spears or the arrows being shot by your friends. Are you... Okay, you've lost interest. Is that how it's gonna be, good sir? You're just gonna ignore me? Hey, my voice will be heard, man. Person. Maybe you're a woman, I don't know. Woman. Person. Oh god, no. Okay, man. Can do this, see? Now we're on more equal footing here, aren't we? Don't you agree that this is a lot better than you just wailing on me while your friends are pelting me with giant death arrows or javelins or whatever the hell you're doing, I don't know. Doesn't that feel a little better? Yeah, I see your friends over there. Does that mean that I can in fact hit them too? Because I think that might be a bit of a help to kind of get rid of these guys. Okay, they were actually using bows and arrows, I think. Okay, my arrow seems to be quite lacking in strength there. Yep, it's just... I don't know if it's actually even reaching them, to be honest with you. It might not be. In which case, it's kind of emasculating, you know? But, you know, whatever, right? I guess. Fatty? Really? Oh, wait, no, okay. You're talking about the Viking guy, right? Yeah, where is he? Oh, he's over there. Patrolling with his, wolf dog. Oh, God. Oh, jeez, no. My God. They're shooting exploding arrows. Can I, in fact, hit you from here now? Or is that still not a possibility? Well, I can. Will you hit me, though? That's the question, right? I hear the Viking clanking around in his armor. I'm expecting him to... There we go. Yeah, if you'd like to follow me, I would like to perhaps end your life, as well as that of your wolf. I mean, your animal is kind of like, more or less, he's, you know, he's kind of innocent. Oh, damn! Backstab does a lot of damage to these guys. Awesome! You know what? I'm happy that I learned this about you. Wolf, are you going to howl and cause, bad times for people, or no, right? Okay, good, thank you. Okay, so... I think the strategy for this DLC is to kind of like progress a little slowly. Maybe not take drastic steps and not get blown up by exploding arrows. That is some advanced technology for these times, guys. Exploding arrows? Am I not reaching him? What's happening here? Oh, I'm hitting below. It means okay. Gotta compensate for that. Right? I appear to be hitting him, but I don't know how much damage I'm actually doing. Maybe I just continue this until he just drops dead? It might actually be faster for me to wait for him to have a heart attack at this rate, honestly. Because I have no indication of how much damage I'm actually doing. He's flinching a lot, but maybe that's just because he's a flincher. You know, some people just, you know, tend to be naturally a little... squirrely and flinchy and all that stuff. Maybe that's him. Maybe he's just it's not actually hurting him, but then just the fact that maybe as a child he was traumatized by a needle. Maybe he was playing out in the streets of, New York, Philadelphia, or something? I'm not saying New York is in Philadelphia, okay? I'm like listing New York, comma, Philadelphia. I've never been to either of them, but I've heard stories, especially about like Philadelphia. And I've seen It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. And I can tell you pretty much from that show that it's not sunny in Philadelphia. So maybe he was in the streets of Philadelphia playing around, you know, as a kid. And then he... I don't know, I guess maybe he just happened upon a crack den and he was playing outside. And then he just... he was playing with some hypodermic needles or something and he just got stung. And then his mom freaked out and all that stuff. And, you know, maybe he got Hep B or something, or Hep A. I don't know which Hep you get from hypodermic crack needles, but... maybe that's why he's got some kind of fear of sharp, pointy things. Which begs the question, then why is he an archer when he has to be around sharp, pointy things the whole time? And I think I might have actually used up pretty much all of my arrows to zero effect, it appears. And there appears to be a Viking over this way. Viking dude, if you'd like to... maybe come fight me. I in this case, I would appreciate you actually coming at me, bro. And maybe not doing that. Okay, yeah. You could also not destroy my camera. I don't know what that was. But yeah. Whatever you did just there to hurt me, that's what I don't like. Thank you. See, that's more like it. Doesn't that feel a little better, a little bit of a, you know, straighten out your back and whatnot, and all that stuff, maybe? There's another one. Guy with an axe and, axe and whatever, roaming around with his pet wolf, guard wolf, maybe? I hear stomping around, which is never a good sign. He apparently froze to death, I guess. Okay, whoa, dude. You came out of nowhere, my friend. Just came out of nowhere. Like a weird baby, you came out of nowhere. His baby's gotta come out of somewhere, right? I mean. Maybe our old butthole baby. That would definitely be unexplained and, unexpected is what I meant, not unexplained. I just explained where the baby came out of. It came out of a butthole. That's why it's called a butthole baby. Which is not where babies come from. I assure you, babies do in fact come from storks. They are dropped off by storks. And if the parents don't like the baby, they will in fact send the baby away and keep the stork. Which is why sometimes you see people with pet storks. That's kind of the explanation there. They didn't like the baby, decide to throw it away. No, not throw it away. I'm not talking like, it's a dumpster baby. That's a terrible, terrible thing. And honestly, it's the worst thing ever. So just don't throw your baby away in a dumpster. But I'm saying that, you know. Thank you. That was actually exactly as I planned. He got thrown away like a dumpster baby. But anyways, what I'm trying to say is that... What was I trying to say? Oh, that the parents send the baby away, right? And then they keep the stork, is what I'm saying. They don't throw the baby away. That's terrible. It's a terrible thing. Don't ever do that. How do we get on the subject of dumpster babies and storks and all that stuff? I don't remember. This doesn't look like a good fall. Is there ever a good fall? I mean, yeah, I actually like fall. Not falling, but I like fall. As a season. I almost said as a weather. It's like, what? Fall's not a weather. Unless it's raining men. Hallelujah. And all that stuff. Millwood battle axe. Is that where I am? Millwood? Maybe? So I know there's a twinkling lizard thing over down yonder. Can I, in fact, hit him with my rapier? That's the question. And I got the ethereal oak shield. I don't know if that's a good thing or what. And the answer appears to be no. So whilst the little titanite lizard is waiting, I will in fact try to equip a better weapon with which to pummel him and take his sweet, sweet body and ravage it. Rather mercilessly, I might add. Poor guy. All he was doing, just chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool. Maybe shooting some b-ball outside of his school. Because I don't know where his school is, right? I don't know where he lives. Maybe this is, in fact, his school. Maybe there's, like, other little scurrying lizards around, and he just happened to be kind of in his own world. He seemed out of it. Because they usually scurry around and they, you know, run away from you, right? But this guy didn't. And I... Is this where the other guy dropped? Oh, shit. And I can't reach his, Yo, dude, I can't reach your loot. Can you die again in, like, a proper fashion, please? I mean, I actually like that you died there. Good God. There's this disgustingness just growing on the side of your building, guys. I think you might need to do some... guys, I think you have some kind of, like, mossy growth, or... It's not even moss, it's like... mildewy kind of stuff. That's disgusting. Mildew is moss, isn't it? I don't know. I mean, I don't know anything about that kind of stuff. Thankfully, no mildew where I live, so it's always a plus. And I can't kill that tree yet. Wolf, are you freaking out for any particular reason, or just like one of those like wolves that like to freak out every now and then? Yeah, you appear to be a wolf that just likes to freak out every now and then. So I killed your wolf friend. Does that enrage you in any way? Maybe not. Maybe he had no emotional connection to the wolf. Maybe just using the wolf for his own personal gain. Oh God. No! 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 You son of a bitch! Get the hell away from me, man. Dude. Not cool. Did your little weird thing even though I dodged you and shit. That's what you get, buddy. Stabbed you right in the butt. Which I assure you, does not feel good. Happens to me all the time, I know. Take it from me. A professional butt stabby. Oh yeah! That's how you die, son. To some little meddling little jerk who's like half your size. That's right. Anything over this way, maybe? Maybe some hidden items. You know what? At least, since we're out in such an open area, there's no chance of me missing, like, a hidden wall or illusory wall or whatever, right? Maybe? Or maybe I'm just, like, missing everything. Who knows? I might be, as a matter of fact. It's very possible. I mean, I'm sure I've missed things that were, like, right in front of my face before. Is this gonna collapse, too? Guys, I don't need homeward bones. Why can't you personalize your holiday gifts for me? Like, why does it have to be homeward bones? I have an infinite use homeward bone anyway, so I don't see why it's necessary for you to give this to me. I feel like it's kind of a lazy gift, and I feel somewhat unappreciated, and I'm not gonna lie, I feel unappreciated. Miss, are you going to come to life? Yes, you are! I just stabbed a tree several times. Not quite as sexy as you might think it is. Oh shit! She's just targetable from the get-go. Oh damn, what are you doing? Oh shit, what the hell is this? Nonsense! Miss? Stop it, please. Thank you. Thank you for responding to my, my violent outbursts by making yourself dead. I'm just going all genocidal on these. Oh shit. I made a terrible mistake. I have made a terrible mistake. The worst possible mistake I could ever made. I have just made it. Things are about to get very bad. And that wolf is just still rolling around. What's happening there? Okay. Whoa. Dude. You're just kind of like popping in and out of existence here, man. That's not cool. Can you hit the... Okay, dude. If you couldn't hit the damn tree that was standing in between you and me, why couldn't you have just said so? Why did you have to like actually just shoot that arrow at me, man? Not cool. Where are these other wolves? Are they just faffing about? God, I hope you guys are just faffing about. Please? Tell me that I can't in fact just hit you with my arrow. Thank you. Okay, can I target the right guy, please? What, do they become untargetable once I've hit them already? I understand what's happening here. Okay, whoa, guys, I get that you're excited. But you can get your Kanye tickets online too, okay? You don't have to come at me with your weird... Oh shit, oh god! Which tree is doing that? Tree person? Please stop. Are you actually moving? You do realize that's not how trees work, right? You can't do that. Miss, you can't do that. Please stop. Thankfully, these wolves are not the brightest. Which is quite a relief, I gotta tell you. They're not like... Oh god. Okay, good. They're not like the wolves in that movie with Liam Neeson. Liam Neeson, not Neesum. He's a knockoff Liam Neeson. No. They're not like the wolves in the Liam Neeson. The wolves in the movie with Liam Neeson. What I'm trying to say. I forget what it's called. It's a kind of like ambiguous ending and all that stuff. I don't want to spoil it for anyone in case you do want to watch it. I like Liam Neeson. I think he's a good actor. And I'm pretty much all out of arrows. And that's it. That's the end of my arrows. Fantastic. Great. Okay, so now we're just going to have to, I guess, revert back to sword and board, which is perfectly fine with me. I actually prefer it this way. Okay, dude. Oh god, he's got like two wolves by him. Maybe I should not. Maybe I should try to get the wolves to attack me first. Aggro the wolves? Oh god, there's like 20 of them. Jesus. Okay, I've made a terrible mistake, guys. And I apologize. I didn't mean to bother your sleep. Or whatever the hell you're doing. It was kind of weird wolf orgy thing. Which I'm sure... Oh god. Just keep popping in and out of existence. Just kind of surprised me there. I'm not trying to be racist that I just got super spooked by the mere sight of you. But I got super spooked by the mere sight of you. Oh god. And your buddy is still firing arrows at me, isn't he? Or does he stop because he's actually stopped existing? Like the whole out of sight, out of mind thing happening in real life. Like literally. I've got the mind of a 5-year-old child. Which is a... Oh god, that's what he did last time. Okay, I see it. I see. I'm starting to understand your patterns of attack here. Kind of. I'm not doing incredibly well, but, you know. Still taking hits here and there. But, hopefully I'm getting a little better. That was a terrible, terrible dodge. And I'm aware it was a terrible dodge. I know. I know it was bad. Thank you. Yay, got some bows and arrows, which I don't think will be incredibly helpful for me right now. Because they're also in extremely limited supply, but, you know. Tree ladies? Can I stab you in the back, maybe? No? Well, I mean, if that's how you're gonna play it, then I guess that's how you're gonna play it. Which is fine by me. Fine by me. And it's really creepy how your hair kind of blows in the wind. Because I'm pretty sure that's not where the wind is blowing right now, but... Hey. I'm not gonna tell you how to live your life. As long as you don't tell me how to live my life. And I guess that's the end of the DLC. That's kind of it. It appears to end here. No, wait, there's more, isn't there? That's what I was afraid of. I was afraid that there would be more. Can I get to a bonfire now, please? Please give me a bonfire. This is ridiculous. I haven't seen a bonfire in, like, the last... Yeah, pretty much the entire time I've been here, except for the very start, you know? And this seems a little unfair. I'd rather avoid... Oh, God. See? Right there. Right there. See that? I'd rather avoid having to do this whole part all over again. So I'm gonna Ember and get some more health. Oh God. I hear more than one wolf. Yes, I do. There is in fact more than one wolf. And there's a good chance that I will die here. So maybe I should run into this building. Maybe the big wolf can't follow me in here, which would be amazing, as a matter of fact. No, 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 let's not Ember. Let's no, let's not throw a firebomb either. Let's in fact kill this wolf. And then maybe drink my Estus? Thank you. That's what I was planning to do this whole time. But instead I've been throwing firebombs and doing all kinds of weird stupid shit. Not at all what I had intended. So it appears that you're not in fact representing my will, your character. Okay, good. So at least all the wolves are... The small wolves appear to be dead now. The big wolf, however, is still outside thrashing about and... Maybe he's a little hungry, I don't know. Maybe he needs his kibbles? I don't know what wolves eat. I'm assuming they just eat people? And sheep? You know, like the whole... No wait, that's a coyote. Right. I was gonna say, roadrunners, but... No, that's a coyote, so... Is a roadrunner like a real thing? Or is it just some kind of like desert ostrich? Because I always figured like maybe roadrunner was just an ostrich, right? It kind of looks like one. Is that it? He gets a half health and then he dies? Like what's with that? Is it just bugged? Like I don't get it. What's happening here? Thankfully, I survived that encounter. Because I was, I actually used my brain a little bit there and I managed to, you know... kill off the small wolves before fighting the big guy. Oh god. Please. Please tell me there's a bonfire somewhere nearby. I can't live like this, guys. Can't live like this. This is ridiculous. I need a bonfire. I'm a man with needs and desires, okay? Right now, my need and my sole desire is just get a bonfire. Right? Not talking anything big. Just a small little bonfire where I can maybe refill my Estus flasks and save. Because we are getting close to the end of the episode here. That would be greatly appreciated. But right now, it appears that you're denying me this. And I don't understand why. Like, look. There's a change in scenery here. Right? Oh god, and there's even a death trap. Leading to some ungodly, like... pitfall, which death trap and pit. Well, not exactly the same, but you know, it's similar enough, right? And okay, so she's unkillable right now, but I'm assuming they will all come to life at the exact same time. Yes, as I had expected. Yep. Okay. Good. Now they're all alive at the exact same time. I still can't kill her. Oh God. Some kind of weird frostbite crap happening to me right now. Do they grab you? Oh shit, what? Oh my god. Wow, lady. Holy shit. Your breath just kind of like flows, eh? Okay, so I'm assuming that was a grab attack, so I should probably avoid those things. Shit. And there's a fly there, and... And wolves, and oh my god, where the hell's the fucking bonfire, please? Stop! I wanna... get me to a bonfire, because it's the end of the episode. Please. I just need a bonfire. Something. Something. To just... help me out here. Please. But... maybe we'll do that... oh, thank God. Yes. Bonfire. Holy crap. This is the perfect spot. Yep. Let's leave it off here and come back again in the next episode. So, thanks for watching and have a good breakfast.